Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are looking at the must-know formula in Excel, Excel's number one formula as of today, and that is the Xlookup formula. Now, as part of this tutorial, I'm going to show you four examples of how to use the Xlookup formula. Once you know all four of these, you'll be an expert in no time. It's very, very simple, but a really, really handy formula to use, so I highly recommend you stay all the way to the end. And don't forget, if you like what you see, please click that like button, put a comment in, or even subscribe to the channel. It'll be really handy. So let's get started. In the table in the middle, I have the World Cup cricket results from 2011 and includes the date, the match, and the winning team. I want to get the winning team coach name and also the match type from these lookup tables on the left. So first thing we do is start the Xlookup function by typing Xlookup, open bracket. Now what we're going to do is going to try and find this particular value, in this case India, and we're going to find it in this lookup table over here. Now I'm just going to lock those cells so we can drag the formula down, press comma again, and what I'm going to return is the corresponding coach name that links next to the country name. I'm going to lock those cells again and press comma. And the next part of the formula is going to ask if there is no winning team, for example, in this game here where there was a tied match, what is the result you want to display because there is no winning coach? And I'm going to type in no winner. I'm going to close the brackets and press enter. And you can see the Gary Kirsten was the Indian coach as part of the World Cup cricket team. And if I drag that formula down, we have now filled up all the coach names for all the matches and the winning team. And you can see here where there was no winner, it's come up as no winner as I specified in the formula. So that was the first example of the Xlookup formula. We'll go into the second example where we are going to look up the date of the game and reference this small table of when the types of matches started. So for example, the group matches started on the 19th of the 2nd, the semi-finals on the 29th of the 3rd. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't have an exact match here, but we are going to look for an approximate match and bring back the appropriate match type. So we'll start again with the formula Xlookup. And this time we are going to look up this particular date. And we are going to look it up in this set of data here. We'll lock the cells as per usual, comma, and we're going to bring back the match type over here. Lock the cells. We're going to continue the formula with a comma, if not found. Now, every date is going to be found, so we're going to ignore the if not found and put another comma. And you can see here, we're not going to do an exact match, which you'd type in zero. We're going to do an exact match if it comes up, or the one prior. The exact match or next smaller item. So it'll bring back the date that's the previous one that you're searching for. So we'll do minus one and we'll close the bracket. And you can see that's come up as a group match. I'll drag this down. You can see that the 28th of the 2nd is not part of this list, but what's the first date that it can find before the 28th of the 2nd? It is this one here, and it's brought back the group match. Now I'll drag this down all the way to the bottom, and you can see the quarterfinals start from the 23rd of the 3rd, 2011, and it's brought back the table exactly how it should. Again, it looks complex, but it's really, really simple. The approximate match Xlookup. Okay, so we've gone through two examples of the Xlookup formula. We've got two examples to go. Once you know all four of these, you will become an expert at Xlookup, so I highly recommend you stay all the way to the end. The next thing we are going to do is we're going to search for these team names here in column K, and we're going to search within this big table for each of the team's first win and the furthest stage they got to. And a little spoiler, the furthest stage India got to was the final, and they won the whole Cricket World Cup. They were the best team in 2011, and this was very upsetting because my team, captained by Ricky Ponting, didn't even make the final So congratulations, India. So let's get started with this formula. Equals Xlookup. And we're going to look up the team of India. And we're going to look it up with the comma in this column G. We're going to lock the cells. And what we're going to bring back is the date from column E. Lock the cells. If there is no time that this team won, I'm going to bring back the value and type in no wins, comma. We want an exact match, so it has a little pop-up, the exact match being zero. We want to match India, the word exactly. And the final part is, do we want to search this list from the top to the bottom or last to first? So first to last or last to first. We're trying to get the first win, so we're going to search from first to last, being one. Close the bracket, press enter, and now we have the first win for each of those teams. I don't know, I can't think of a team that may not have won a game. Maybe Ireland. So if I change this to Ireland, no, they won as well. It looks like every team might have won a game. Maybe Kenya. Kenya. So there we go. There's a team with no wins, and it comes up with that default no wins. Okay, so we are going to look at the fourth and final example of Xlookup. And what this is a wildcard lookup. I'm going to search for the team name, for example, Australia, and try and find the last time that Australia played a game or a match and bring back the match type that it was. Now, it's not an exact match because Australia isn't listed here by itself, but it will be part. It'll be a wild card as part of this column here. So let's get started. Equals Xlookup. And this time I'm going to use the wildcard features, which is the star, which is a complete wildcard. Anything before this word. Join it with an and. And I'll bring back the team name of India. Again, and. And I'll use the star again. So what that part of the formula is saying is it's going to look up India as part of this word, this cell. It doesn't matter if it's the beginning, the end, in the middle. It's going to try and find India. Press comma. I'm going to look it up in this set of data here. Locking the cells, comma, and I'm going to bring back the group match or the match type from column I. Lock the cells again. If there's an error and the team cannot be found, I'm going to ignore that. So I'm going to press comma again. And we are not looking for an exact match this time. We are looking for a wild card match. So I'm going to select number 2 and press comma. And this time, instead of searching from the top of the list to the bottom, first to last, I'm going to search from last to first, because that's going to bring me the last time that India played a game. So I'm going to just double click here, or you can type in -1 and close the bracket. And you can see that the furthest stage that India got was the final, which I mentioned before, and I don't want to mention again. And I'll drag this down for each of the other teams, and you can see that Australia got to the quarterfinals, New Zealand to the semifinals, and Kenya to the group match. So there you go. That is 4 examples of the Xlookup. I hope you got it. Go back, re-look at the video if you want to get some further instructions or try again. Really handy. You'll be an expert at this function, the number one function in Excel. Please subscribe. See you next time.